main bottom comes into the broodstock pond here. We drain it down when we're ready to strip the fish. We then place them into the two separate tanks, one for the males and one for the females. Search the trout, make sure they're ready to be stripped. We then place them in the anaesthetic tank. From there, once they're under anaesthetic, we place them into the main hatchery where we strip them down. Once they've been stripped, we then place them into the recovering tank. And once they've recovered from there, we then separate the males and females. The males go into the back into the broodstock pond, and the females go across into the main pond for next year again.
The other ones we're talking about, David, see that? It's a hen, and she's never anywhere near it unseen. Look how clean she is.
There's no vent at all, is leaving.
And the vent's moving out.
Yeah, well, that's what, a week, eh? What vent, baby?
Yeah, no, look at that. No vent, no nothing, look.
No eggs either.
Oh, it's solid.
Yeah.
You can see them now, they're starting to go under now.
So are my horns.
Good for your horn.
You don't feel the cold anymore.
Don't put yourself on out thinking it was somebody else.
Aye.
That's it. That's it.
That's
a money shot.
Mm-hmm. You want more brought down?
So what? Can I go too?
Aye.
And there's a problem with about 2,000 eggs on there. The average is about 1,000 eggs to per pound of fish. But it can be caused by what they call overcrowding. Like too many fish in a holding pond.
I usually skip out the farting.
Faggot.
Painting the fucking bitty.
Yeah, it's a main market. That's where all your all your albums, don't you? Right. Catch a hatch. So what happens? Get it a bit clear. All your albums will hatch out. And we'll be done through that. The egg will sit in this. Right? And the eggs hatch, the albums start wriggling and moving about and floating through here. As soon as they're born, and they lie in there. And this is supposed to catch the sack.
Oh yeah.
Keep the separate, then you just work that out. It doesn't work. It works to an extent, but I load the sack before it off. But there, in this side, that one's going to in. That one's no boat on, that one's just straight into the tray, and that worked just as well. So what I've done is give her full of snooker. Give her full of snooker. Mm-hmm. You want any snooker for her? Mm-hmm. Graham Dot.
Mm-hmm.
Graham is a friend of mine. Right? So I've got red meat at the back of her pub. So I know the guy will have the problem. You see, because that's her. Snooker light off a snooker table. So picture this up the other way. The light used to sit on the snooker table. So if you can use it, take it away. I take it for scrap. So I brought it up here and we shoot the joints. We put it upside down. This is brilliant for hatching out eggs. It keeps them clean. It's clear in here all year because it's deeper. And we hope if we modify it to fit these in. So we put two baskets in here and that's what I'll put a wee one in just to see how it works. So what we're going to do now is the eggs that we've struck, this is what they call water happening. So what you do now is you leave them sitting about in water, you're waiting for an hour. I usually get them at 3/4 an hour, half an hour, 3/4 an hour. You can see at the end of the day. The damage is all done. Because it happens instant in the river. That just makes the egg solid right. Because before if you press the egg it was soft, you know within an hour that egg will be solid because it's in water now. That's it, they just sat there and now a wee while trying to get the basket. The ones we've struck last week. You can see the solids are even dropping on leather. For the water.
Mm-hmm.
But what I'll do now is we'll get them. We'll speed them up. It takes the dirt off, it washes them through, and next week we'll get filters in. Keeps a lot of dirt out. The burn's going to be not that high this week, but just shows you a bit of dirt in the middle. But you get it anywhere, it doesn't matter where it is. But the secret is to keep them off.